Welcome back, my dear students of class 9. Now let us continue with the lesson. The Sound of Music. Carry on with the sixth paragraph. Now we have seen how Evelyn is going ahead in the world of music with the organs, the senses of the body, taking her to the heights. Now, let's carry on with the lesson. It is intriguing to watch Evelyn function so effortlessly, without hearing. It becomes something very natural for her. She doesn't need any extra effort. In our 2-hour discussion, she never missed a word. She is not able to hear, but she does not miss a single word uttered by the other. How does she manage? Men with bushy beards give me trouble, she laughed. So, somebody with a bushy beard conceals a part of the lip. So perhaps she leaves the lip movement of the people. That is how she manages to learn every word uttered by the people with whom she is talking. It is not just watching the lips, it's the whole face, especially the eyes. Now, how does the girl get the message from the other speaker? It is not just watching the movement of the lips, but it is also the expression of the face, the whole face, and the eyes. The eyes can tell you a lot without speaking, and she is able to catch every expression, every word uttered by the eyes, spoken without words. She speaks flawlessly with a Scottish lilt. My speech is clear because I could hear till I was 11, she says. But that doesn't explain how she managed to learn French and master basic Japanese. Now she is able to speak though she cannot hear. And she says that she is able to speak because she could hear till she was 11 years of age. But how does it explain her learning French and Japanese? It is not explained. As for music, she explains, it pours into every part of my body. It tingles in the skin, my cheekbones, and even in my hair. When she plays a xylophone, she can sense the sound passing up the sticks into her fingertips. By leaning against the drums, she can feel the resonances flowing into her body. On a wooden platform, she removes her shoes so that the vibrations pass through her bare feet and up her legs. So, music pours in through every part of the body, and every part is receiving the music in the air. It tingles in the skin, it reaches the skin, and goes through the skin, goes through the cheekbones, even through the hair. When she plays a xylophone, she can sense the sound passing up the sticks of the xylophone to her fingertips. She feels the music. Leaning against the drums, she can feel the echo of the sound flowing into her body. Her body receives the sound. Standing on a wooden platform, she would prefer to stand without the shoes because the shoes come in between the sound vibrated, the vibration of the sound. It cannot reach her feet, her body very readily. So she prefers to stand barefoot. Not surprisingly, Evelyn delights her audiences. In 1991, she was presented with the Royal Philharmonic Society's prestigious Soloist of the Year Award. Says master percussionist James Blades, God may have taken her hearing, but he has given her back something extraordinary. what we hear, she feels far more deeply than any of us. That is why she expresses music so beautifully. So this is a very prestigious award, Royal Philharmonic Society's prestigious Soloist of the Year Award. India's Jubin Mehta also got it, Royal Philharmonic Society's award. Then there is James Blades, who says that God may have taken away her hearing power, but God has given her something very, very, very nice, something much better than the hearing power that you and I have. What we hear, she feels, and she can feel more deeply than we hear. That is the reason why she expresses music so beautifully. Evelyn confesses that she's something of a workaholic. What is workaholic? Workaholic is a person who finds it difficult to stop working. She has to work and work and work and finds enjoyment in working. I've just got to work, often harder than classical musicians, but the rewards are enormous. Yes, if you work hard, you have to be rewarded naturally. Apart from the regular concerts, Evelyn also gives free concerts in prisons and hospitals. So for the people in the prison, for the convicts, you know, she gives some kind of entertainment free of cost. For the people who are sick in the hospital, she gives some entertainments. She also gives high priority to classes for young musicians. That is a way of encouragement given to the young musicians. She will give classes. Anne Recklin of the Beethoven Fund for Deaf Children says, she is a shining inspiration for deaf children. They see that there is nowhere they cannot go. That means seeing Evelyn, the deaf children can feel that yes, we can reach anywhere we like. If we desire, if we like, we can get it. So she is a source of inspiration, a shining inspiration for the deaf children. Evelyn Glennie has already accomplished more than most people twice her age. She has brought percussion to the front of the orchestra, that means popularized it, and demonstrated that it can be very moving. She's given inspiration to those who are handicapped, people who look to her and say, if she can do it, I can. And not the least, she has given enormous pleasure to millions. Yes, rightly so, she has been a source of inspiration to many people, to millions of people. She has shown to the world that if you wish, you can get it. You only have to have strong determination, and you have to keep on pursuing. You have to work, and every moment of your work will give you a reward. So, this is our Evelyn Glennie. Without the power of hearing, has achieved the greatest height of success in the field of music. So now, tomorrow, please write down the answers of these two questions of thinking about the text. Write it in few words, one or two sentences, not much. Number one, answer these questions in a few words or a couple of sentences each. Write only the first two. How old was Evelyn when she went to Royal Academy of Music? And number two, when was her deafness first noticed? When was it confirmed? Please write it down neatly in your notebook and show it to me through our watcher. Thank you so much, children. Hope you will do your assignment. Thank you.